One, two, three. Hi, everyone. My name is Alexander. I'm a developer from Blend4Web, and I'm also participating in development of Blender. Now I would like to talk about the present and the future of Blender and Blend4Web. So first, let's define what is present and future. The present is, of course, Blender 2.7, and when I'm talking about the future, I'm referring to Blender 2.8. If somebody is not familiar with Blend4Web, Blend4Web is a framework for developing of 3D web applications, and Blend4Web is closely integrated with Blender, and actually you have no need to use other tools, just Blender and Blend4Web, and publish your models or prepare your models for more rich applications, and so. Blend4Web by design was designed by to match Blender viewport, and today Blender internal viewport is most developed. So Blend4Web uses Blender internal viewport features, its shading system, and also Blend4Web has its own extensions for shading node systems and for additional effects which could be configured on the additional panels. So let's look at some live examples to show how these extensions are working. First example is this sunny oasis in desert. You can see translucency. It's translucent leaves of palm tree. You can see bloom of environment. You can also see this bloom on water. You can see animated texture on the water. You can see soft soft shadows. And let's go to the next example. It's a Pokemon. Actually, this Pokemon demo was released before the game Pokemon Go became so popular, and it was made by our artist, who is a big fan of Pokemons. So here you can see reflections caused by red crystal. You can see also glow on crystals. You can see animated steam around this character, and also you can see motion blur. Next example uses similar approach, and here you see animated flames. So attractive example, really. And let's go on. Blend4Web also supports parallax effect. It's commonly used effect, so it's just available in Blend4Web. The next demo is a demonstration of depth of field effect. And here is shown bokeh effect. Now I would like to get down to the low level and to try to understand at which technology point Blend4Web and Blender now today are. So I highlighted here some important points. First is the start of history of OpenGL. Second is release of OpenGL 2.0, and third is release of OpenGL 4.3. So Second and third point had opened for us significantly different techniques of rendering. For example, with OpenGL 2.0, we have gotten fragment and vertex shader, and also in extensions we have received possibilities to make render to multiple targets. So it became available to make to implement deferred techniques with sufficient performance. And actually, deferred techniques, for example, deferred lighting, has some advantages. For example, you are not limited in amounts of lights. So, yeah, you can see that you can use really a big amount of lights. And the second point, which is a modern, has a modern approach, for example, compute shaders, and it's used, for example, in Doom game, released in 2016. So here is used clusterization, and actually here is used forward rendering, which and the limitness of amounts of lights is resolved with a clusterization of camera fruits too. And where is WebGL? And WebGL actually here. Today, WebGL 1.0 is widely used and stable, and it is available on a wide range of devices. But actually, it's today, for example, for mobile devices, you can't do you can't implement deferred rendering with OpenGL 1.0 because of lack of these extensions for multiple render targets. And WebGL 2.0 actually has these abilities in its core, but anyway, for mobile devices, deferred rendering is too heavy, so it's hard to have a deal with all these buffers and to not explode, for example. So we think that Blend4Web, or that Blender viewport, that future Blender viewport should use most modern techniques and should not be limited by, for example, deferred lighting, which really making limits on diversity of materials. So I would like to say that such materials that are available for implementation today with current system must be available in future viewport. And here is actually real commercial projects made by our partners. You can see on the left non-photorealistic shader, and actually non-photorealism, I think, perfectly suits for such purposes like infographics. And on the right, you can see realistic material of diamond. And actually, it looks very realistic, I think. So today, shader node system, which is really outdated, and it's today is still really has many abilities and very flexible. And we are participating in Blender development, and we are already have committed some patches. So here is our contribution. First is vector transform and normal map and particle scene for was ported from cycles to viewport. It significantly expanded possibilities for Blender internal node system. Also, we have added support for cube maps and environment, and cube maps for environment and materials. And we have added support for environment lighting for Blender internal viewport. And you can see how it looks before and how it looks now in Blender 2.78. On the top picture, you can see how you can see impact of environment lighting, and on the picture with elephants, we can see reflections. Yeah. And with these patches, actually, today you can achieve some renders which are close to modern engines. You probably saw this article posted by Eddie Burrows. So he compared these two renders. And actually, I think that you can achieve more close result by implementing Fresnel effect. And somebody can say that Blender internal viewport is not able to render dynamic reflections. Yes, it's correct, but actually Blend4Web can do this. And today Blend4Web, I think, has all possibilities to make non-photorealistic materials and photorealistic materials. Yeah. And implement closer implement these materials to modern engines. And we, of course, going to do our work on improving Blender and Blender 2.8. And we really think that the future of Blender is great, and today is a great team formed for around Blender Viewport project. Yeah, and we will participate in it, and of course we will working on we will working on future viewport and on integration of Blend4Web and Blender. And now I would like to show you how fast Blend4Web is developing. So the first example is we have made reflections, we have improved reflections, and before before only opaque materials can be reflected, and now you can see that transparent materials also can be reflected. We have improved our depth of field effect. We added bokeh effect. So you also saw, you already saw example with umbrella, and here is just another one. We have added support for all Blender internal shader nodes, its vector and RGB curves, its color ramp, and these nodes allows you to make various gradients. And also, we have added support for vector transform, which allows you to convert your vector data between object world and camera space. And also, normal map has been supported. it allows you to make normals for your object, and also and even mix many normal maps with different UVs. And also we have supported for added support for tangent shading. It's not working today in Blender viewport, but it's working in Blend4Web, and we think that we will add this. We will do this work for viewport too. Also, we have released our first long-term support distribution. It's production-ready distribution, and it will be receiving bug fixes, and API will be kept for 1 year. And it is available for our pro users. And also, we have very significant event for us. It's the first Blend4Web conference. It was held in Moscow, and the official language was English. So if you are interested, you can find our presentation on YouTube. And I would like to invite you to the next Blend4Web conference, which we are planning on next spring. The next point is contests. At the beginning of this year, we have started to make contests. And the first contest was related to a new year and Christmas, and we were so pleased with results of our contestants, so we decided to continue to do this great things. So today we are holding a retro car contest, and it's still open, and you can actually you still have time to participate in this contest. And here is just winners of past contests. This year we also started to fill our material library, and today we have around 30 realistic materials. We have improved our logic node system. We have added possibility to make interactions between JavaScript and between logic node system. And we are using it in development of our game called Pythagore's Tale, which has been released this year too. And actually, we develop our logic node system in a workflow-oriented way, so we separate programmer work and game designer work. Next point is a render profiler. It's really important feature. It allows you to see which part of your model most heavy, and you can now optimize your shaders. So red tone, you can see it's for heavy shaders, and green tone for light shaders. We also have made deep optimizations on GPU and CPU. First optimization related to better batching. We implemented cluster algorithm for batching. Next is we use geometry instancing extension of WebGL, and it allows us to save a lot of RAM and to decrease calculations on vertex shader. Also, we have optimized our mesh data, and it's important for some old GPUs. So rearranging of mesh data cost on some systems very big increase of performance. And of course, we have optimized our JavaScript code. Also, we worked with gamepads and actually with virtual reality. And for gamepads, we have done configurator, so you can configure your pad or wheel. We just you can map your buttons of your device with a standard layout, which you can see on the picture. And for VR, we also have implemented configurator. And actually, we worked with a lot of virtual reality devices. For example, Gear VR, it's Oculus Rift, it's cardboard devices. Yeah. So, and the next game, actually, it's actually supports VR and gamepads. Now you can play such wide screen. My first experience to play on such a screen. You can try. Who want to try? Just try. Yeah. So you can see. You can see how all new features, and that we are really working hard to make these features available in our every month release. And we're really happy that we are using Blender and that our users can do really cool features and and even innovation features. Yeah, you saw Ring example with Ring Boutique. So I think that it's really innovative. Yeah, thank you for your attention. If you have any questions. If you have any questions, just remember my face and ask me afterwards. Thank you.